Ladies and gentlemen, you've got a scientist actually today. You haven't got a historian, an archaeologist. You've got a scientist, but a scientist who's been interested in the history of the Vikings ever since he found out that the football team he supports since the age of five has a Viking name. And it's Tranmere, who for years I used to say that Tranmere is unique in being the only football team in the English league with a Norwegian Viking name. And that was okay until last year when they let me down very badly. They got relegated out of the Football League completely. Now we operate in the National Vanarama Conference. So yeah, that's how I got interested in the Vikings all those years ago. And of course now research into the Vikings has become multi or interdisciplinary with many subjects contributing. I mean, history and archaeology are still the lead subjects, but science is now making an important contribution. This is about science and the Vikings, and also some speculation that the Vikings may have had some scientific skills themselves. And of course, it's a great honour that I follow a string of very distinguished lecturers. The very first Håkon Håkonsson lecturer was the great Magnus Magnusson, who gave this seminar, Håkon, the old Håkon who. Not only was he a very famous broadcaster for Mastermind, of course, but also series on Vikings and Chronicle, but he was a distinguished Viking scholar and translated, along with Pálsson, many of the Icelandic sagas into English. And 15 years ago, he wrote the foreword to a book that I wrote about the Vikings in the northwest of England called Ingemann's Saga. So I wrote to him. His address was in the phone book, so very easy to find, asking if he would do this, expecting no reply. You know, these famous people, no time for people like us. And within two or three days, this wonderful reply came back saying, "Steve, I'd be delighted to write a foreword. What's more, if you send me the draft, I can maybe look through it and make some suggestions." I think he was just making sure that what he was putting his name to was okay, you know. And sure enough, I sent him the draft, and within a few days, this package came back. I opened the envelope. This waft of strong tobacco came back. Apparently, Magnus was a great pipe smoker. And the manuscript was full of green ink. He'd been right through it with a fine tooth comb. It cost him the whole weekend, this, just for me. And for the love of it, no charge, no fee, this was Magnus. Now, this year, we updated this book to take into account all the archaeology, all the DNA and everything's been going on in the Northwest over the last 15 years. And it came out last week, Ingemann's Saga, third edition. Now, I contacted Sally, Magnus's daughter, to say if this was okay, and it would be okay to include the old foreword from Magnus, and also would it be okay to write a short tribute to him? And she was absolutely delighted. She said that my dad would absolutely be thrilled if you did this. But what Magnus did do was to dispel this impression that the public had, that the Vikings were just a bunch of adventurous, violent, aggressive people, and there was nothing else about them. Far from the truth. he, more than any in the media, was able to show just what an articulate bunch of people the Vikings were. Sure, they were great adventurers, they were great navigators, explorers, they were great craftsmen. The skills in building these clinker boats, seafaring boats, oceanfaring boats, was unparalleled. They were great lawyers. The word law, law comes from a Norse word. And they were great parliamentarians with the assemblies or things. And from the Wirral, where I'm from, we have a site called Thingwall, where the Vikings had the parliament. So he had this great ability to convey this wonderful diversity spectrum of these attributes for the Vikings.